let's have a look at grouped lists in ServiceNow. Grouping lists allows you to categorize information based on a specific field. This helps you summarize and organize large lists, making it easier to identify patterns and trends. By grouping data by a particular field, you can see how many records fall into each category. This can be helpful for quickly understanding the distribution of data within a list. Let's start grouping an incident list by priority. There are different ways to group a list. An easy way is by selecting the column context menu or column options. Alternatively, you can right-click on a column header and group that list by that column. In this example, I'm going to group this incident list by priority. Let's see how the group list looks like. You can see a list of groups with a count of incidents for each group. This list indicates that there are 40 total incidents and there are 5 groups in this list. The icon next to a column header indicates that grouping is applied on this list based on this particular field. To group a list based on another field in the list, I can easily repeat the steps and group it by a different field. Or if I'm no longer interested in grouping my list, I can simply select Ungroup and I can see the original list. Another way to group a list is by selecting the list controls or the list context menu. This will allow you to group by any fields on the table. You can access the list context menu by clicking on the record name, which in this case is called Incidents Context Menu, or by right-clicking the title bar. Let's group this list based on a state. I can see that there are 3 groups listed here based on the filter applied on this list. In this example, I can only see the new, in progress, and on hold states. Given that this is an active incident list, these are the only available states. I can simply clear the filter and regroup by state. Now I can see an additional state for closed incidents. To ungroup, you can simply select none and this will take you back to the original list. The difference between grouping by column context menu and the list context menu is not all columns are available or visible on your list. Although you can personalize your list and add additional columns so you can apply grouping based on that column, you won't need to do that with list context menu because all fields are listed here. And you can simply browse the list and find the relevant grouping that you want to apply. When you group a list, you can simply expand or collapse the groups. Let's try this. This time, let's group based on assignment group. And I'm presented with 7 groups in this list. As you can see, the first group says empty. And these are the incidents that are not assigned to any groups. I can simply expand a group by selecting the arrow next to it. Or I can choose to expand all groups at once by selecting the arrow on top. By re-clicking, I can collapse a list of incidents in a group, or I can choose to collapse all groups in a list. Let's ungroup this list. You can also apply sorting in grouped lists by count. This is achievable by selecting the Group Sort menu or Group Sort options, which allows me to sort my data based on ascending or descending order. Let's select count descending and see how the list would look like. I can see the list of groups sorted by count. So in this case, I can see Joe employee with 7 tickets as the highest number on the top of the list. Count ascending, we'll do the reverse and list all colors with the lowest number of tickets at the top of the list. You can change back to the original list by selecting color ascending, which is the default value. This will display the data regardless of the record count. If you would like to see the list of records based on a group, you can also click on a group link. This filters your data based on that group. In this example, I can only see my incidents. I can navigate back to the list of all incidents and apply different filters to my list, group my list, and sort my list so I can see the list of records that I'm interested in and find information easily.